A farmer thought he'd found an ancient relic, but then he realized it was the rarest of spiders. When Lee Wanua stepped into his orange orchard one November morning in 2016, it was unlikely that he'd expected anything other than a fairly routine day at work. The Chinese farmer lives just outside of Chengdu, in southwest China, where the humid air can make winters unpleasantly cold. Lee was an ordinary farmer. He is one of the most prevalent surnames in China, second only to Wang, and it's shared by over 100 million people worldwide. But while it was the surname of the emperors during the illustrious Tang Dynasty, Lee himself couldn't lay claim to any royal blood. With Lee being a citrus farmer, his thoughts were likely focused on trying to ensure a strong orange crop. That year, orchards throughout China had been hit by citrus greening disease, reducing their expected yields. In fact, though, the health of trees generally isn't much of a concern in Pujiang County, the area where Lee lives. Often referred to as the Garden of Chengdu, Pujiang is a place more than 50% of which is covered in trees. More than 40 million people in China survive on an annual income of less than $350 apiece. In addition, around 500 million of the nation's inhabitants each have to live on a daily income of below $5.50. While busy at work on the orange farm, Lee saw what looked like an unusual object sitting just in front of him. It was unlike anything he'd ever stumbled upon while walking through his orchard. The presumed object didn't quite fit in with the brown soil, the green grass, or the orange of his fruit. The farmer initially believed that it was some type of cultural artifact, perhaps a pendant or medallion that had been lost centuries before. So, as he moved closer towards it, he quite possibly thought that he might have something valuable on his hands. Lee's assumption that the object was a historical artifact seemed credible. Pujiang County's roots go back almost 2,500 years, when it was created after the Shu Kingdom had been conquered by the Qin Kingdom. However, just when Lee had come to the conclusion that he'd found a long-lost man-made object from which he could potentially make some money, his discovery moved. The farmer suddenly saw a body in motion and realized that the supposed object was alive. Spiders are fairly common in Pujiang County and in China as a whole. There are more than 3,000 species of spiders in the country, including two types of tarantula: the golden earth tiger and the Chinese bird spider. Meanwhile, after getting over his initial shock, Lee subsequently carried the spider home with him in a plastic bottle, and once his neighbors had heard about what he discovered, they rushed over to his house to see the strange specimen for themselves. It was called a Chinese hourglass spider, a species that was perhaps once feared to be extinct. Since 2000, it had been sighted on just 5 other occasions, meaning it was an extremely rare creature. The book in which it was first recorded, meanwhile, is Arya, the oldest known Chinese dictionary. The tome's 15th chapter contains an account of a creature that closely resembles the Chinese hourglass spider. As the spider's name suggests, its lower abdomen is shaped like one half of an hourglass. Unlike many hourglasses, though, the abdomen is a muddy brown, allowing the spider to blend in with its surroundings. Another more generic name for the creature that Lee found is trapdoor spider. This name derives from the fact that the animal lives in an underground burrow. The Chinese name for the hourglass spider is Li Shi Pan Fu Zhu, and its Latin-derived scientific name is Psychoclasmia ricketti. The spider is of extreme scientific value, entomologist Zhao Li told. Li's discovery was made even more remarkable by the fact that the hourglass spider is usually found in Zhejiang and Fujian provinces rather than Sichuan. And although it was known as the creature that can tolerate temperatures as cold as 55 degrees, the winters in Sichuan tend to be far colder. Meanwhile, as peculiar and even frightening as the Chinese hourglass spider might appear on first sight, some people nonetheless keep spiders of the same Cyclocosmia genus as pets. This is possible thanks to the spider's calm temperament. although its rarity and strangeness also make it attractive. On average, the female of the species has a disc with a diameter of half an inch and is just over an inch long. But even if the size of the spider's body is modest, its market value certainly isn't. Lee discovered that the spider can sell for around 12,000 yuan, which is the equivalent of about $1,900. And having learned this, he decided to trade the spider to someone looking for a new pet, which is likely to secure him a sum of money greater than what millions of Chinese people earn in a single year.